الرجيم. الحمد لله السميع النذير الذي ارسل الينا الهادي البشير محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى اله وصحبه اتم السلام والصلاه والسلام. Dear brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treasured us with so numerous bounties. Among the one that we enjoy the most, at the same time, we are going to question the most about is the bounty of having children. Those who are married, they have their own siblings, their own children. And those who are not yet, I'm sure they are longing to have family of their own and children. This bounty is a trust that we're going to be asked about in the hereafter. It's a trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusts us with, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala going to reward us, going to let our good deed continue if we left behind, if we leave behind precious sibling, precious power, those who will remember us with good deed, those who, when people see them, they will make dua for the one who gave birth to them, or the one who taught them, or the one who raised them the way they are. On the other hand, there will be a cause, there will be a reason to be, for us to be cursed, to be punished, if we fail to fulfill the trust that subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusts us with. We'll be questioned about that in the hereafter. And long after we're gone, people will curse us if we left behind bad power, bad sibling, bad children, children who get ill effect on the society around them. People will curse them and will curse those who raise them, let them be the way they were, they are. So it's a trust. It's not only an enjoyment, it's not only a bounty, but it's first and foremost a trust that we have to fulfill that trust. And this started, the task started by selecting a good wife. First and foremost, among the rights of children, they have rights upon us. Our children have rights upon us. Among their first right is to choose a good mother for them. So as I said, women تنكح المرأة بأربع لجمالها بحسبها بمالها فاظفر بذات الدين تربية دار أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says صلى الله عليه وسلم, women are looked for for marriage for based on four qualities. Then he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, for their beauty, for their honor, for their family, for their race, for their legacy, for their wealth. And he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, choose the one with religion, with good religion, that may your hand be filled with God. Because if you did not choose well, if you look for beauty only, beauty will go, beauty will not last. After some time, that beauty will fade away. Longer last the time. After some while, that beauty will be gone. And if you look for beauty, you will see some other who are more beautiful. And you keep searching for one and one. But for wealth, also the wealth, a catastrophic effect may, this wealth, as it comes, it may go. One minute, one day. So many stories about people who, at the beginning of the day, they were wealthy, at the end of the day, they were bankrupt. And if it is for race, you for legacy, for the family, for their honor, again, that honor, that legacy, that fame, that family you look for, will have a price for that. You have to pay. You have to, so many things you have to give in that this legacy of family. But when you look for the religion, this is the one that will last. The religion that will, Rasulullah SAW said about describing the righteous wife, نعم متاع الدنيا المرأة الصالحة. The best of the blessing of dunya that a human could, a male Muslim could enjoy in this dunya is a righteous wife. إذا نظر إليها صرت. If you look at her, she will please him. وإذا غاب عنها حفظته. And if he is away, it will save his honor, save his children, save his wealth. So the first right for the children is to choose a good brother for them. We spend out of the 24 hours a day less time with the children than the mother. The mother is the one that actually sculptures them the way they are. The one that raises them, give the first basis of education to them. And based on that foundation she put forth, they will go, they will grow up. And if she is righteous, then the whole building will be righteous, hopefully, inshallah. And this is among the rights of the children to choose a good mother for them. Secondly, when the husband passed to his wife, he should remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not only for enjoyment that the pleasure of that enjoyment will, no matter how it will last, it will vanish at the end of it. But it's also, we are serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by this. As one brother jokingly said, we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by procreation as well. Because we are hoping that out of the sexual intercourse we have with our spouse, we'll have good children after that. People who will serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People who will multiply the number of Muslims. So we should remember that when we pass to our wife. By remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying the dua that Rasulullah SAW taught us. Allahumma jannibna wa jannib al-shaytan wa razaqtana. Allahumma sallallahu alayhi wa sallam barakatuh said this dua that should be said before the husband passed to his wife, which is, O Allah, save us and save the one that will be getting because of this intercourse from Satan. So we started by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then goes on by choosing a good name. A name that will stick with the son or with the daughter for him all life. It should be a name that he will be pleased with. A name that will not make him shy or feel shame later on. A name that will have beauty in it. Either, whether it is a name of one of the prophets, a name of one of the good companion, righteous companion, or a good Muslim, or a name that has beauty in itself. And it should not be a name that make him shy or he'll know later on when he called by that name. Then the rights goes on and how we raise him, how we bring him up to be a good Muslim. We should know that all of us, all humans, will be questioned once they die. The beginning of their questioning started from the time they died, from the time they put in their grave. Where they're going to be questioned, before questioned, that every one of us will be questioned, including our children, of course. Who is your Rabb? What do you say about the one who was sent for the Messenger? And what is your religion? Salam. These three questions. Salam. So we should build the foundation, bring him up to be a good conscious Muslim. And for us to do that, we have to be a lead example for him. We should not be say something and be somewhere else. We should not tell him, be honest, don't try. And then when the doorbell rang, okay, I'm not here. What is that? This is a bad example. Or when somebody answered the phone, he will turn him out, tell him I'm busy. Okay. Be where your action, let your action be where your mouth is. Be a lead model, a role model for him, a lead example. That when he grow up, he will be imitating you and will be either like you or even better than you. Because this is what benefits you in the hereafter. Not only that you do fulfill the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trusted you with, but also this will be an ongoing charity for you. That's what said, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنَ آدَمْ مِنْ قَطَعْ عَمَلَهُ إِلَّا مِنْ تَلَابٍ. If the son of Adam died, no more good deeds for him. He's done. He cannot do anymore. He's dead. Except three things. One of them, وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُوا لَهُ. A righteous son. And this goes for a son or daughter. As long as they're righteous. يَدْعُوا لَهُ. Invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his sake. But notice what he said. He did not say a wealthy son or an educated son or a son with a prestigious position. No, he said, waladun salih, righteous. This is the most important. Because if he's not salih, if he's not righteous, he would not even remember you. But when he's righteous, he will remember you and he will invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's supplicate for your sake. And if he did not do so continually, his action will let people, as I said earlier, the beginning of the translation, supplicate and make dua for the one who gives birth to that righteous slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's an enjoyment, it's a trust also, and will be questioned about. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very brief about the khutbah translation that the Imam mentioned at the very beginning of the khutbah. And the Imam went on to elaborate for further points that I don't have the time, full time for translation because I'm almost done. And I'm sure that Dr. Nabil is maybe waiting for us for his class. So I conclude by supplicating for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen and practice to this day listen, and make us among those who know the truth and abide by it and practice it, and make everything we say, everything we do for our sake in the hereafter. It will be for us if we implement it, if we do fulfill the knowledge we learn, and it will be against us if we neglect it, if we choose to go the other way. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم.
Brothers, please return back to your classes, sir.
This is Jibril. Just say.
pero ginamit yung bus.
Alunin mo yun. Kasi doon lang sa sakyan eh.
Natawad! Doon!
Dito, dinugarap nila.
Ay, pagkatuloy niya.